Hi, this is Reporter's Take. I'm Sakshi Batra and I have with me my colleague Priyanka Sahai, and we are here to talk about the latest development around FDI policy on e-commerce. Thanks very much, Priyanka, for joining in. Now, we've had a couple of discussions before this on this development, and we've seen how the e-commerce sector is unhappy the updated FDI guidelines, as well as they are pressing for an extension of the February 1st deadline.
Right.
Now, what's the latest that you're hearing from the traders' body? Is there some bit of opposition on that front?
So, well, Sakshi, turns out that CAIT has actually written to Ramesh Abhishek requesting that none of the requests that have come from perhaps the e-commerce industry, which is the companies, should be taken into consideration, and there should not be any further extension of the deadline, which is February 1st. The government sources have actually told us that for now, there's not going to be an immediate change. However, there are so many concerns that are coming from the industry. So the government might as well look at all of these towards the end of the deadline, in the sense that once we come close to the February 1st deadline, the government may take a call on what needs to be done.
Yeah.
But as of now, immediately, there's nothing that's going to happen. Secondly, CAIT has said that, you know, in principle, whatever Press Note 2 says is much the same as Press Note 3,
okay,
where it comes to issues such as, you know, predatory pricing, or the marketplace is not supposed to be impacting the pricing directly or indirectly of the products. However, there are certain things that the government needs to clarify further.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And for that clarification, I'd like to point out that there is a big bone of contention, and that happens to be the private labels.
That's
what sort of clarity do we have on that front?
So, turns out that the government has actually, I mean, soon after the government came up with Press Note 2, which happened on December 26, it came up with another leg of clarification, stating that the government would not have any concern with the nature of the product that is actually sold on the marketplaces. Now, this directly points out towards the private label products that the e-commerce companies sell on their platform. However, this is like the government saying both the things at the same time.
Yeah.
On one hand, where Press Note 2 says that the government, that the marketplaces cannot have equity in any of the sellers that sell on their platforms, it also says that the government is not concerned about the nature of the products that are sold. Turns out that in India, all the marketplaces that actually sell private label product mostly have an arrangement with the sellers wherein they maybe promote the sellers in one way or the other, have equity in these sellers, who thereafter come up and sell their manufactured or their procured products, which happens to be private label in nature, on the very own marketplaces. So when the government has gone ahead and said both the things at the same time, the Traders Association has actually demanded a further clarification on what this means and what exactly is the stand of the government on this.
Absolutely. So there is more clarification definitely needed on this front, both for online and for offline traders. But as far as the upcoming e-commerce policy is concerned, can we expect all these issues to get clarified and all resolved in that policy?
That's a good concern. I mean, one of the biggest concerns that the industry has right now, Sakshi, and turns out that we are still a little bit away from the e-commerce policy. However, there are talks of the draft being prepared, and soon we'll have hands on the final draft of the e-commerce policy. Now, turns out that there will be multiple level of consultations with the stakeholders that the government is going to have, and we can only hope that much of these concerns are actually addressed in the policy for once and all. However, as per our communication with the government also, we have been told that the industry can always raise concerns, and depending on what the government can do and to what extent can they take an action, they will ensure that all the concerns are properly addressed. So that is what we are hearing for now.
Sure. Thanks a lot then, Priyanka, for sharing all these details with us. We can sure expect some more developments in the coming days, as this is not just going to end here. There are lots of clarifications still awaited by the offline as well as online trading body as well. We'll just have to see if the February 1st deadline also is extended or not. Some of the questions are still unanswered, and we'll just have to wait and watch out for as to what the government really comes out with as next on this FDI policy on e-commerce is concerned. Thanks very much for joining us in this edition of Reporter's Take, and do stay logged on to moneycontrol.com for more news and updates. Thanks for watching.